Hello there, you're watching Proactive London. Joining us today from Diversified Energy, we have the Chief Executive, Rusty Hutson. A very good day to you because we're going to talk about your latest set of results and what you've described as an active first half of 2021. So we'll dissect it together and go through the details. So tell us really, first of all, how you feel about the results and maybe take us through some of the key points and the highlights, if you would, initially.
Yeah, sure. It was, as you said, very active. We did $342 million of acquisitions that we either closed or announced in that first half. We also exited the first half at an all-time record production rate at 116,000 BOE per day. So as you see those acquisitions take effect. And then also, you know, free cash flow, $117 million of free cash flow, 20% free cash flow yield. So all in all, active, but very profitable at the same time.
Mm-hmm. Can you maybe explain that the pre-tax loss as a result of the non-cash impairment caused by your hedging positions? Yep. Explain that to us.
Sure. Yeah. Well, as everybody knows, we're a hedging company. We make sure that we're locking in prices typically far out in advance to make sure that we're locking in the margins that we need, not only to operate the business, but to pay down our debt and also to pay our dividends. And so most of our hedges are done within a 2 year period in advance. And so, and we see this across the industry as the prices, especially oil and natural gas, have risen very quickly through the first half of this year, that a lot of those hedges obviously are in a negative mark to market. But people need to realize is that that's positive from the standpoint that means prices are going up. And future production, we can be locking it in at higher prices than what we've seen in the past. And so if you look at our last 2 years in 2019 and 20, we had over right at $200 million of gains associated with our hedges. That's obviously reversed a little bit here, but it gives us the ability to hedge going forward at higher prices.
Mm-hmm. Got it. You delivered record production for the period through really a combination here of organic and inorganic activities. Maybe take us through some of these, if you would.
Well, the organic side, you know, we continue to perform at a high level on our existing production, marginalizing the decline rates in the portfolio and making sure that we're taking care of business there. And then obviously the growth that we've seen comes from the acquisitions that we've done. Specifically, the first in that first half, we closed on our Indigo transaction, and so those productions that production started to roll through at the end of the first half. So we had really good organic production from the standpoint that we were able to marginalize our decline rates, and then we had the growth on top of that.
Mm-hmm. Rusty, it's clearly been a very active period for you in 2021. Three material acquisitions, giving you a foothold now in a new region. What is the significance of this new region entry, and how do you expect to sort of maximize value from these acquisitions?
Yeah, well, this region gives us the best opportunity to really replicate what we had accomplished already in Appalachia. Mm-hmm. Lots of fragmented production, lots of different ownership, lots of assets to acquire, a lot of assets on the market. And the ability to scale, drive efficiencies and synergies in the business, drive down costs, and also to recognize a much higher gas price in this region. And so between all those things, obviously, it just made a lot of sense. And with what we've already acquired, we're already seeing opportunities to take advantage of that scale that we've already built and to work on some of those costs and some of those expenses and to lock in pretty high margins down there. So all in all, we'll continue to be very active down there. I think we'll see some more opportunities and you could see things happen there in the second half.
We must mention ESG and your ESG credentials and how much this features in your operations and priorities as a company.
Well, we say this all the time. Good ESG is good business for Diversified. Mm-hmm. It's a high importance to us. We put a lot of emphasis, a lot of focus on it. We've actually moved our investor relations director, Teresa Odom, into a full-time role. Now we've made that a full-time role around ESG, and we'll continue to be very active in reducing emissions and emissions intensity, And then also, you know, from some of the other aspects, you know, social and governance. What I would tell you is we're having a capital markets day, I believe somewhere at the first part of October, and we're going to get real specific around how we're going to address ESG going forward, the amount of capital we're going to deploy for it, the types of projects that we will look at, and the emissions reductions that we're going to focus on. And so that will come, there'll be more to come on that here in the next month or so.
As we enter the second half of the year, I can't believe I've just said that. It's crazy.
I know.
Gosh. And what should your shareholders look out for then?
I think it's just more of the same. You know, we pride ourselves in consistency, making sure that people understand the model, understand what we're trying to accomplish. I think you'll see us look at a lot more transactions and be, you know, opportunistic there. And to continue to put these, the businesses that we've already acquired, making sure that we integrate those as seamlessly as possible. And then, you know, looking into 2022, trying to drive as much cash flow as possible for our shareholders.
Rusty Hutson, thank you so much from Diversified Energy here on Proactive.
Thank you so much.